Hello and welcome back to more Harry Potter LEGO Years 5-7. My name is Zeppelin G993 and I just casually transformed from a skeleton back into Harry because that's what it's all about being a wizard. You've got to be on your toes, you've got to be prepared to do anything and be anything, even if it means turning into a skeleton. Because I was just exploring this lovely cauldron we've got over here. It looks quite disgusting at the moment, and that's the skeleton sort of potion, because you know, essential that is to learn at school. You know, you've got to have those sort of skills for life as an everyday wizard. Anyway, in this part, we're going to be doing level 2 of Year 7 Part 1, Magic is Might, which I've been really looking forward to playing again because the chance to duel Umbridge once again, you know, which is always a lovely opportunity. I'm going to let Ginny Weasley get involved because I really do think that most of Dumbledore's army, you know, they show how keen they are at the end when Harry returns to Hogwarts. So really, I think they would like to join Harry, Ron and Hermione on their adventure. It's just, of course, Harry's like, no, I can't accept any help whatsoever because that would be way too easy and obvious to have your help. So we start off in this area of the Ministry of Magic. And there are there's three in this first area. It's three collectibles. First one over here. So if I get to this. This one's strong. Hagrid in a suit. Whoa. Check out that bad boy. We've got five ducks here, five rubber ducks, you know. So we just casually destroyed them all. No one noticed anything, no one goes, hello, what's this about? And that gets us the first quest piece. Now we have Hermione over here. But this is quite simple really, because it's all in one area, which is quite nice. Sorry Ginny, I thought you were Hermione. Please don't be offended. There we go. Learn Hermione, learn it. Speak the ancient runes. There we go. Harry as Albert Runcorn. Of course, we've got to get True Wizard, so make sure, of course, to get loads and loads of studs. At every opportunity to casually go through someone's hat and take their studs. But then why would someone leave studs in their hat? Makes no sense. And then we have, I should mind mistake, there's four collectibles in this area then. The fourth being another quest piece within these lights. Had to get three lights, which really is as simple as it comes, really. You know? That's not difficult at all. Just do. Oh, I got a text. Oh no, I didn't get a text. Alas, I'm not that popular. More of an, it's one of those things where I've got Facebook on my phone and it has a little bing every time I get a notification. And usually it's like, oh, someone's messaged me, but now it's an event invite. An event which I probably cannot afford to go to. Which is like, botherations. Okay, so far we have that quest piece. Down the other end is the other light. And then the other collectible is within Umbridge's office. Just enjoy this, the genius of this. And the fact that this happens. And voila! Panic ensues. Wait, come on, one. Oh, I mean, not one. Hagrid, rather. Do your thing. I really do find it amazing that no one stops to look at these guys doing their thing over here. And the eye, so at least the eye would, you know, it would see you there at least. It'd be like, what the hell's going on? It is a weird one. Some more money in here, should you want it. There's a fair few in this part to collect. I can't remember how many. I think it's around the 50,000 mark, which is a wee bit tricky. This makes sense here. Keep out of sight of the eye here. So actually, serenade it. At least you're not there, so it's not completely obvious. And in you go. Also over here, more studs, and then last light. Ron as Reg Catamol. Fantastic! This is weird, right? So we get Ron as Reg Catamol as a character. We don't get Ron as Dragomir Despard. We just get Dragomir Despard, the person himself as a character, which is, I don't know. I just don't understand that. It's a weird one. blue ones. Must get the blue ones. So, another thing here. Obvious what you got to do here. Key. And there we go. Just casually go in and boom, maybe. Now this table here, you kind of destroyed a whole table. And as it's Umbridge, believe me, she will not miss it. It was, you know, it's really interesting reading the whole Pottermore extract about Umbridge. If you haven't read it yet, I recommend that you do. I mean, even if you haven't got to that part yet in Pottermore, I certainly haven't, but you can read it on other websites. And it's really interesting to see this insight into Umbridge's backlife, you know, and just sort of the context that caused her to, you know, become such a repellent character. Because I do think she's even worse than Voldemort, because she really just, you know, sort of uses... What's going on around her to pursue her own, you know, actions, her own dreams. That's what I'm going for there. It's a weird, she's just a horrible character, simple as that. Makes you feel really angry and annoyed, literally, yeah. So, yeah, some people say, like, I think J.K. Rowling herself said that she's even worse than Voldemort. Hates her more than Voldemort, and I think that's true. I despise Umbridge because she sort of, because even worse, you know, Voldemort is a bugger and a half, but at least he accepts that's what he does, and he doesn't try to purvey it as anything other than pure evil. Umbridge is like, oh no, I will have order. She sort of makes it all up as an excuse of like, oh, this is, I'm doing it for the greater good sort of thing. It's like, well, I'm calling poopy on that. To open that. Next collectibles are all in this elevator area here. So on we go. What's that there? Another hat. You always see those hats on the stand, but no one ever wears them, man. Why do you say? Because those hats are ridiculously sized. Almost like they're too big, like a sorting hat size. But it's a hat which is nice, but not a hat you'd wear on a casual everyday basis, I think. Not even a wizard would be like, no man, this just isn't groovy. So, there's three in this area. You've got to be Dark Wizard to get most of them as well. So, there we go, Death Eater time. Casual random Death Eater. Open the chest, open the scroll. It's like it's Voldemort, baby. Groovy Voldemort poster. And there we go, another quest piece. The other one is, the other two are in here. We have both a character and a student. God knows how many lessons they've missed just being in there. Like, seriously. And it's like, yeah, I was stuck in an elevator in the Ministry of Magic and a Death Eater rescued me. What kind of teacher's gonna believe that? It's all rubbish. Nothing in there, alrighty then. Just looking everywhere for stuff now. I've still got a fair bit to get, and there is quite a bit you can get at the end, but you've got to know where it is, because the last bit of the level, of course, is the Dementor Chase, which is a bit stressful because there is like one collectible there that you've got to get, and you know, if you don't get I'll get the pom pom to get it. Go on, pom pom. Not pom pom. Arnold the pick me puff. I just call him a pom pom. That's what I imagine he's. Yeah, it's not. I think it's a nice name, pom pom. It does look like a pom pom, like a cheerleader's pom pom. I'm gonna stop saying pom pom now. Yeah. So there are a few, there's plenty of blue studs and the occasional purple stud in the last section. It's just one of those things where, you know, you're very stressed out because you're trying to escape Dementors, as anyone would be. So it's one of those things where you've really got to try and get as many as you can beforehand, so that you're not relying on getting loads when you're being chased by a pack of Dementors. And now it's battle time with Umbridge. I'm going to take a sip of coffee because it's that sort of situation where I need to be ready. Ah, that's a good cup of joe. Right, it's, I have hammer coffee, it's let's battle the hell out of this place time. These guys would be more threatening if they didn't look like postmen to me. It's just the hat and the costume, the uniform, oh god, I've got to change it. The thing is as well, your other character, your supporting character is useless. They do nothing, like, seriously. You just stand there and watch, like, oh, this is a nice place, isn't it? Oh, it's all very tidy, it's very big, isn't it? Oh. You're in a chair there, aren't you? What are you in a chair for? Why are you so special? You've got to be in a chair. Why are these people firing at us, Harry? It's very annoying. I'm just going to stand over here and watch all of them. It's like, so screw you. And Mafalda just like, I've got to maintain my disguise here, because, you know, rather than help you guys, like, oh dear, dear, dear. And yeah, you think the Patronus would, you know, help us, would help Umbridge, but no. That could be a cool part of the boss fight. Patronus versus Patronus. Never heard that before, eh? And Yaxi's just like, oh, I'm gonna boo you instead, because booing is so much more effective than firing an actual spell. And then he goes, actually, you know what? Screw that. So go on, Jenny, have some fun. Don't send out Arnold, though. It won't do well for that. Back, go! This has got to be proper embarrassing for Yaxley as well, for God's sake. It's always been the yellow one, which I haven't got. Yeah, must be proper embarrassing for Yaxley, like, you know, be defeated by a 16-year-old. Come on, change your spell. That's more like it. Oh, I reckon it'll be this one next. Oh, but what do I know? He said, come on, Naxxay, come on, be a man and let the Potato shield down. There we go. Umbridge will do the whole, let's throw loads of objects at Harry, because that strategy's been working so well so far. And, oh, I missed it. Seriously, so much gets destroyed in this game. So much waste. It's not the sort of game we want to encourage. You can't just do this in real life, guys. You can't just waste everything. Here we go. Right. Oh, brilliant. Actually, I've got this one now. Ginny, what are you doing? There's no time to be jogging on the spot. No time for exercise workout. Ginny, you're crazy. Ginny, stop following me. Ginny, why on earth are you? Ginny, you're crazy. Oh, for God's sake, you distracted me. Blinded by the love, blinded by the light. Ginny, I'm gonna go left now, don't follow me. No, Ginny, no! I'm gonna go right now, Ginny, just leave me alone, Ginny, I'm trying to fight an evil teacher. And there we go. Done. Now, here's the time when it all goes a bit pear-shaped. Oh, that's close. Blue ones here by the doors, get those. Should be a purple one behind the statue here on the right. There we go, that was just about, did it in time. Oopsie. That doesn't matter though, because you get away anyway like that. Whew. So yeah, as it sort of turns to the left of that corridor, go behind the gold statue, there'll be handful of purples, which are very useful to get in True Wizard, and of course you'll get the final quest piece, so boom baby! Whoa! Naked time! There we go, health quest complete! Boom baby and all that! Harry Albert Runcorn, Ron Reg Catmull, and Mafalda Hopkirk. True Wizard and all that, all the good stuff. Complete. Student in Peril, so 128 gold bricks. As you expect, it's free each time. Follows a very similar pattern, that doesn't it, these parts. Right, so how many stats have we now got? 29,000. 29 million, rather. Still got more than we'll ever need. Sort of the equivalent of the National Lottery, but for wizards, really. Well, rather no, because actually it's more like Sickles and Galleons, isn't it, for wizards. I used to have this game. I used to have a board game called Harry Potter Diagon Alley. It was so much fun. Have to go around buying stuff with silver. It'd be like the first person to get all the stuff in Diagon Alley wins. Like a board game with like, oh my god, it has Sickles and Galleons, had to buy like wands, had to buy potion ingredients. So, so good. Seriously. So I wonder if Harry that. Any more that I've not got for mining yet? One of those things where I've just realised I haven't bought cactus here for a while. How many am I behind on? So Harry wanted to mine it, I've got all their cactus in this part. Mad-Eye Moody, I didn't buy him. Does that mean I didn't buy cactus on the other part? I can't see any blank spaces now, that's the thing. Oh well, I'll leave for another time. But that's a good buy, and I've still got more studs than I'll ever need. So there we go. Always go for free play mode on Magic as Might, because it gives you another chance to battle Umbridge and cause more mayhem at the Ministry. And that's what being a wizard is all about. The next part will be level 3, which is where we go back to Godric's Hollow. In Godric's Hollow, that's actually the level name. See you then.